the hills of Tennessee, a man named Slaughterhouse Jones dwells with only one purpose, revenge. To some, he is a myth that has been forgotten in time. To others, he is no more than an elite rogue military operative. But to the United States military, Slaughterhouse Jones is an object that they have sought to destroy ever since he discovered that the American government ordered the death of his beloved wife.
Is anybody there? I know somebody's out here. Show yourself now.
Yeah, he, I don't know how I lost him. I'm on it, sir.
Cousin Ricky, thanks for the birthday present, man.
Anytime, man. Be careful with that thing. That's an MP40 anti-tank rocket launcher.
Hey, y'all, but look at this mask that I found.
That's a pretty cool mask, man.
Yeah, I'm gonna go get me a gorilla dip.
All right, man, let's see how that thing shoots.
Oh, you want to test it out?
Let's do it.
Oh, boy.
The local rednecks often had links to the close-by army bases. Jones used them as the middleman to receive weaponry and supplies, which helped to fuel his attack on the U.S. military.
Wicked sweet.
Sir.
Jones had many close encounters with the U.S. forces, often taking them by surprise.
Hey man, watch your back.
Oh, Tell me everything you know. Tell me everything you know.
I don't know anything.
You lied.
No, the United States military is after you.
Alright. I'll let you live.
Jones uncovers information through forceful interrogation that reveals the president himself as the black-hearted fiend who sent the order to kill his wife. The president's Tennessee estate would be the perfect place for Jones to exact his extreme dark revenge on the man who stole from him his one and only true love.
Shit is alone.